Uncle Donovan McNabb joining the show. Thanks so much for taking the time. 13 seasons at quarterback in the NFL. I know you know what it takes to win, but now you're quite the hockey fan because, of course, your nephew Darnell, also your niece Sarah Nurse, we'll talk about her later. But starting with Darnell, have you had any conversations about with him recently about this whole return to play crazy tournament style?
It's funny, we've been talking just about every week, and we keep an update on each other of seeing how obviously the family is doing, what he's doing to continue to stay in shape and prepare himself when the doors open for them to get back out and be active again. And he's been hitting it as a professional, and that was one in which I've had Darnell in my life pretty much since he was born, and I took him here to train when he was about 11, 12 years old, and had him for a couple of years, and just tried to teach him about being a professional and always being ready for when the time comes. And he's continued to follow with that path, and he's ready to make something happen this year. Obviously, we know what happened last year. It was a down year, but now to have their two scores healthy and ready to go, and their team pretty much being healthy, it's going to be an exciting time for them to get back on the ice.
Yeah, you mentioned that you used to train with him. I'm sure that was a kid's dream come true, having a professional athlete for an uncle to train with. So what was Darnell like as a kid, and when did you think, wow, this kid could actually make it in the bigs?
Well, as a child, you sort of let things be sort of passive, so to speak, and you just kind of let things go. He was more of a guy that was a go-getter. He was willing to put that time and effort in. He wasn't afraid of failure. So he was going to make sure he'd get the maximum in his workouts. He was going to spend extra time before and after our workouts. And that was something that I tried to continue to teach him at a young age. And he's continued to carry that load with him. And what you see is you're seeing a guy who is determined. He's goal set, goal oriented. He's a guy that's willing to do whatever it takes to help his team win. And that goes well with you in the long run with your teammates. And so for him right now, he's in one of the best shapes of his life. He's had an opportunity to kind of heal his body, obviously staying safe and making sure that he's doing what he needs to do to make sure he and his family are both safe. But now it's time to play, and he's excited about it. I'm excited about it. Only thing about that matchup that you mentioned is I'm from Chicago, and I'm a Blackhawks fan, and I've always told Darnell, for the championships that we won, I always threw that kind of in his face, but I just have to choose my nephew over my team slightly, but we need to get this done.
Yeah, I can't wait to see a picture tweeted out, hopefully, of you in a Darnell jersey. Maybe we can get one of those half jerseys made for you where you're like still cheering for the Blackhawks, but definitely still
no.
Darnell.
No, I won't do that. I'll go strictly Oilers. And it's funny, I remember McDavid back when he was younger, before the big contract, and he was just a baby face. He's still a baby face, but I'm happy for both of those guys.
And we are too. How are you on skates? Have you ever trained with him or tried to work out on the ice?
Remember, I'm from Chicago, so we didn't do ice skating or rollerblading. We did the four wheels and the stopper. So on roller skates, I'm outstanding. I mean, you'll never see a guy turn backwards and roll with the best of with the music pumping. But as far as on ice with one blade or rollerblades, I'm too big for that, and nor will I try it at this age.
That's probably smart, to be honest. And Darnell would just have, bragging rights for years to come that way. So you mentioned, he is getting ready for the playoffs. He's in the best shape of his life. That's great to hear. But mentally, this is going to be such a unique experience for these guys who have never had quite this much time away from the ice ever, probably. And now they're expected to get right back into playoff form. So, as a guy yourself with plenty of playoff experience in your years in the NFL, what's some advice that you might give him in order to just mentally prepare for something like this?
Well, at a time like this, you need to refocus. You have to treat this as if you're coming out of the offseason going into training camp, and that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to find ways to get themselves in game shape. They have to rebuild that chemistry in which they've had while the season was going on. It's going to take some time to kick the rust off, but I think what you're looking at is you're looking at a young team that's not filled with a lot of old veterans. These young guys can click very fast, and they've stayed in contact throughout this whole process. So when you have that, that's an added bonus for a team like the Edmonton Oilers. And I think also what you have to take into account is, just a couple years ago when they made that pretty decent run with McDavid as their leading scorer and Darnell as their defenseman, before Drysdale, they were able to understand a little bit more about what playoff play is all about. So now that experience carries over to this year. And for the new faces that are part of this team, they'll just have to follow the lead.
I think you sound like a great hockey analyst. We might have to have you in studio here in a little bit. I do want to mention Sarah, your niece, because she's an excellent athlete in her own right. We mentioned her right at the beginning of our interview, but what has it been like for you to watch her journey and all that she's accomplished?
Well, you know what? One thing that people have to understand is the Nurse family is a hockey family. And it's not only just Sarah, it's her brothers that are playing. Darnell and his family, he's the only one on the ice. His two sisters play basketball. Obviously, Kia Nurse being Darnell's sister, so she's playing professionally with the WNBA. But I'm excited to see just the flourish and how they're developing as young men and women. And for Sarah, she's putting her foot down and she's standing up for what she believes in. She's playing very well. Remember, she's an Olympian. She's a silver medalist. So she's the only one in the family that can say she made it to the Olympics and won a medal. She was second team All-American at Wisconsin, played in the national championship game. So I just give credit to all of my nieces and nephews just for being able to grow and develop into the men and women that we all expected. And I just try to be a role model for all of them to set the tone and just prepare them for what life presents to them.
Yeah, and along those lines, we actually had Darnell on as a guest recently to just talk about everything, not just the playoffs, but also what's been going on in the world lately and his experience as a black athlete. Now, I know, different sports for you, but I'm sure you've experienced plenty of your own racism and prejudice along the way. Is there any particular message that you would really like to share with people watching or a change that you'd like to see in terms of progress towards more equality or anti-racism?
Well, first and foremost, I think this is an opportunity for all of who are nervous about starting the conversation, or one who may have grown up in, different situations, meaning that the teachings and the beliefs and what you should say and react to certain individuals. They need to present that now to try to find out what it is that black athletes are going through. And for some of them who don't believe that they're racist, they make comments under their breath or may say things that make them racist. So they need to find out why is that and what they can do to change. And I think for the Black Lives Matter movement is something not only just in basketball or football, but it's also in hockey. There are a lot of African Americans in hockey, including my nephew Darnell. And my message to them is stand up for what you believe in. This isn't a time where you want to sit back and just say, well, it's going to be okay. No, people need to know what you go through on a daily basis. And if it's, if it's racial profiling, if it's police brutality, if you've grown up in an area where you've played hockey all your life and parents or fans have made racial comments, people need to know that. Because in the sport of hockey, people just think automatically because there are a lot of Europeans that are involved, there are, Caucasians that are playing. So it's okay. But it isn't okay for guys like Wayne Simmonds and Darnell and the rest of those guys. I think this is a time for them to come together and also bring along the guys who are like McDavid and those big name guys, Sidney Crosby, to be a part of it and express what they really feel and just the experience that they've went through with some of the negative attention that they've received.
Yeah, a lot of negativity, but I do think there is a lot of positive coming out of this. And like you said, having those conversations is so important right now. And I really appreciate you taking the time to talk about it as well. I know you mentioned that you still are able to work out every day. You look like you're in great shape. So what's going on in your life right now, post-playing career?
Well, training quarterbacks out here in Phoenix, Arizona, and also coaching girls basketball. So staying active that way. Also, I work out every morning, like I said. Actually, after this interview, I'm gonna head on downstairs to continue my workout. But it's just for me, just staying fit, staying healthy. I have four kids of my own, so I want to make sure that the daddy 5 to 10 years now is still in good physical shape, that I can continue to travel with them and see them play and watch them develop and grow into men and women that I know that they can do. So they have goals and dreams of playing high level basketball, football, baseball, whatever it may be. So I want to help them push, get that extra push to get them where they want to go.
Well, stay safe, stay healthy. We'll let you get back to your workout so you can continue doing all the good work you do. Thank you so much for the time and the conversation.
Thank you, and let's go Oilers.